Hi, everyone. Oh, isn't the world beautiful in this season of fall? I hope you're noticing and giving thanks to God every time you notice a beautiful leaf or a beautiful flower. Today, we're going to talk about a person that we read about in the Hebrew scriptures of the Bible. His story is long, and it is in the book of Genesis, which is the very first book. Remember that the first five books of our Bible, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy, are also a sacred text of the Jewish faith, the Torah. The man we're going to talk about today was named Abram, and his wife's name was Sarai. Later in the story, God changes Abram's name to Abraham, which means father of many nations, and Sarai's name was changed to Sarah. So we're going to use Abraham and Sarah as we're talking today. Abraham and Sarah were very old at the time of this story, and they were faithful to God. God once spoke to Abraham and told him that he wanted Abraham to pack up and start walking to a new place. But God did not tell Abraham where the new place was. That was a very difficult direction to follow. Pack up everything and start walking, but I'm not going to tell you where you're going. Abraham was faithful. He packed up all the family members and servants and animals and tents that they all lived in. Abraham was a wealthy man and had many possessions. He packed up all of them and started walking. God also spoke to Abraham another time and told Abraham that his children's 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 children would be more numerous than the stars in the sky. His descendants would be more numerous than all the stars. This was a very difficult thing for Abraham and Sarah to understand, because I had mentioned they were very old at the time of this story, and they didn't even have one child. When Sarah heard this, she laughed. But later God blessed them with a son, and they named him Isaac, which means laughter. God blessed Abraham, and Abraham was a blessing to many. Let's talk about ways you might think about this story. One thing you might do is go out on a clear night and try to count the stars. If you've ever tried that, you know it's almost impossible. I think there may be more than a Googleplex of stars. You might look at the story in the book of Genesis, in our Bible. Or you might think about counting your blessings. Here's a way you could do that. You could take just a normal jar, decorate it with stickers and with ribbon, and then use small pieces of paper to write your blessings on and put the pieces of paper in the jar. Later, at a special time, your family could pull out those papers with blessings written on them and give God thanks for each one. You might also think about ways that you can be a blessing at home, at school, at church, at work, everywhere you go, by sharing kindness and love and generosity with others. Let's pray together now. We'll fold our hands, close our eyes, and bow our heads, and we'll all say amen together at the end. Dear God, we give you thanks for our blessings and for all the ways that we can be blessings for others. God, we thank you for the stories of the Bible and the lessons they teach us all these years after they were written down. God, we pray in the week ahead to remember all of your people who are in need. And we pray for your guidance in ways that we might help them. We pray always in the name of Jesus, your Son, the risen Christ, and we all say together, Amen. Amen. I hope you have a wonderful week ahead, counting your blessings and being a blessing. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.